Hello there! In this video, I'm going to speak about the ASCII table, Go declarations of variables, and I'm going to make some uses of the function PrintRune that's spoken about in another video in order to relate the first two points, the ASCII tables and the variable declaration. So right away, let me show you what I mean. We're going to write a small program as usual. Go. So as usual, package main, a function main. There we go. And first of all, let's declare two variables in two different ways. So variable A equal and variable B. Oops, there you go. Let's make it an int. So an int will be what we call number 10. And in this case, I'm gonna put it this way, variable b int equal 10. This is exactly the same in both cases, except that the first one is the shorter version. So here, go detects that this is an int. I'm gonna show it to you using PrintRune actually. PrintRune only takes a run as an argument. So if I were to use PrintRune on those variables, well, we should have an error, variable A and B. And let's save it. There we go. PrintRune cannot use variable A as a type int because it takes type run in argument. It's the same mistake for the other one. And there you have it. So as you can see, Go actually is intelligent. It detects itself the type of variable depending on what you put after the dot and equal. So this is equivalent. So now let's try to put actually a run. Let's do it this way. Let's put a uppercase here and let's put b uppercase here. So if I save it here, actually let me change this to a run. There we go. If I save it, we'll still have a mistake because of a very slight detail. Let me show you. Variable A here says it cannot choose a type string as a type run. This is because of the single quotes. The double quotes should be single quotes. In this case, if there's double quotes, Go detects it as a string. If you put single quotes and save it, then there's no issue anymore. There you go. And see, on variable B, I declared the run. It's still the same issue. Like, cannot use B type string as type run in assignment. So be aware of those single and double quotes. And there you go. Now you can print the runes. So if I were to test my program, A and B appear. So there you have it. Now, I want to show you something with the ASCII table. Let's actually show it, an ASCII. And let's check where A and B are. A and B are here on this line. So as you can see, what you need to know about the ASCII table is that it's a basic set of rules for character encoding. The very basic one. It's not the most used one in today's day and age. It's not the UTF-8. That's the one you will hear. That is the most used in today's world. But this is the ancestor of it, and it's a good thing to understand it in order to then get the UTF-8. So you will see probably videos about this one later on. So now let's focus on uppercase A and uppercase B. As you can see, The character A has an equivalent, decimal equivalent of 65, and B is 66. So let's actually go back to our program. And what does that mean? It actually means that if I were to do this, and let me print through another one. And here, let's put backslash n. If I were to do this, change variable a to 65 and variable b to 66 without quotes, what will happen? Well, let's compare it. Exactly the same thing. You still show those two characters are still printed by the output of the program. So as you can see, those are numbers. Those letters are actually numbers in the computer's mind. So knowing that, what would you do if you wanted to print the Z uppercase? Well, simply, so the one, if you use your logic, and with number, not with the character, not this. What I mean is, which number do you need? Well, you need number 65 plus 25. This is a possibility in this case with the PrintRune function. You can actually add numbers inside the parentheses. Let's check it. Let's see if my calculation is actually correct. A, B, Z. There you go. So knowing that, and with this more introduction, you now have the tools to face all the exercises that are coming upon your way. Thank you for watching, and until next time.